We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, and I was told the Patriot cheerleaders would be here. However, almost as good, Chef John Granada from Camille.
Yeah, right. Thanks.
TV Joe Zito.
I almost wore my cheerleader suit, but you know, it's too cold.
That alone would have been enough to tune in for. You guys are here today, and let me tell you, this is the perfect day for soup. You are making soup?
Yes, we're making farro, beef, and porcini soup.
Okay.
And
what is farro, you ask?
Yeah, thank you. Farro, what is farro, I ask?
Farro is actually the oldest grain known to mankind.
Okay.
And I did not make that up.
And like me.
It actually is the derivative of all grains, supposedly. And it cooks up similar to like a barley.
Okay.
But it doesn't look anything like it.
Right.
But if you think about what wheat looks like, and you think about those little things that come off the side of the wheat.
Yep.
And you look at that grain.
And you could see where it would be on here.
Right.
It's kind of cracked down the middle.
It'll crack down the middle,
crack down the middle as well.
Yep.
Okay, so we're going to make this soup here today. Let's tell everybody quickly what we need.
Well, we're going to start out with some beef stock.
Okay.
Preferably homemade, but if you don't have the time, that's fine. You can find it in the supermarkets. Some kale, which is the new superfood for everyone, right? We have some leeks, onions, carrots, celery. We have some plum tomatoes, San Marzano's preferably, some garlic, salt and pepper, some fresh thyme, and I have some beautiful tenderloin tips, but you can use just about any kind of beef as long as you simmer it properly.
All right. All good stuff. We got a lot to get to. Perfect day to make soup. Then we're going to be talking to this guy because he has a big weekend coming up.
I do.
With the TV maitre d'. That's why he's dancing with his pom-poms.
Yes.
Back to you. All right, we are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Chef John Granada from Camille's, Joe Zito here, TV maitre d'.
You know, there's an ugly rumor on the set
yes.
that somebody wants me off the set and they yeah. want the cheerleaders on. That would be absurd, wouldn't it?
I don't know about that.
Show of hands.
Show of hands.
Oh, thanks.
We do still love him.
I thought we had a bromance.
We do still love him. Oh. We are making soup this morning
right.
in the Rhode Show kitchen. We're going to get to it. What do we need to do right now?
We're going
to
sear off some beef for that.
By the way,
there was nothing ugly about that rumor.
there may be a little truth to
Absolute
that.
Absolute truth.
So, anyway, we have some beautiful tenderloin tips. You
right.
can use just about any beef. You could use chalk. You could use
fat. It's bad as a little, so make sure you have clothes on.
Yeah, that's good. But look at that. I mean, that meat looks great. It's sizzling away, cooking all the way through.
John, what is it?
This is beef tenderloin.
Just tenderloin, as opposed to you don't want stew meat or anything.
You could use that, but the thing is, when you use a lesser grade of meat,
right?
You have to stew it longer.
Okay.
So.
So you want to get something that's really a good.
Right, but you got to understand that this is going to cost you three times the amount of money.
Right.
And I know because I'm stewed a lot. So.
But it's worth it.
That's right. Just how you do it.
If you're gonna do it.
Salt and pepper it.
Yep.
And what we want to do is we want to get a nice color on this meat, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna add to this, you know, your basic mirepoix and leeks.
Okay.
So the mirepoix is always carrots, celery, and onions.
And onions.
Right, yeah.
And in this case, we're gonna add some leeks also.
Okay.
Which is beautiful this time of year. This is you know, their time of year.
And
we're gonna wilt all that down, and when we come back, we're gonna show you the steps to the simmering process.
Okay.
And I'm gonna show you the final product.
Okay. Now the meat in here. How long is this actually gotta kind of like stay in here before?
Well, you want to sear that meat so it's got some great color on it,
okay.
and then you're gonna cook down the mirepoix.
Right.
And then we're gonna put everything together, and the whole simmering process is about an hour.
Okay. All right. Good. Hey, you know what? If you're gonna make soup, today is a good day. It's freezing outside.
You got that right.
It is warm in the Rhode Show kitchen. This guy's gonna have a big weekend. We're gonna talk to him about that in just a little bit, and we're gonna eat too. Can't get better than that. Back to you.